Dear students, we have already discussed all important concepts regarding this lesson. We have discussed all vocabulary, important words, new words, their meanings. Today we will discuss passage wise all important things whatever here. Author Khushwant Singh shared in the passage number first, The Portrait of a Lady by Khushwant Singh. Passage number first, author here trying to convince the reader through detailings about the characters. In that, grandmother's character is important. Author introduced the character of grandmother in the first line. Then one more character it is introduced in the first paragraph, that is grandfather's character. But here only the thing is grandfather's character. Here it is described in a such a way that grandfather's portrait, that reference is given, and little bit character description about the grandfather it is discussed in the first passage. So I will refer some words here poet specially, author specially used for the grandfather. My grandfather's portrait hung above the metal piece in the drawing room. So here drawing room is the setting, and specially the metal piece, it is the wooden thing. And if you will view the pictures of that, idea would be more clear about that metal piece. One more thing it is given, he wore a big turban and loose fitting clothes. As the Punjabi people, they are wearing the big turban and loose fitting also clothes and long beard. So here one more information it is given in this. His long white beard covered the best part of his chest, and he looked at least 100 years old. So through appearance it looked like that grandfather is very old, and grandfather would have more grandson or grandchildren. So like this here picture it is created, and through this description we can visualize the important concept. What is that important concept? Concept about the appearance of the new character, that is grandfather's character. Now next, what is there? Grandmother's character. Now grandmother's character is widely discussed in the lesson. Grandfather's reference is only in the first passage. So now about the grandmother, what are the expressions here used in this? My grandmother, like everybody's grandmother, was an old woman. She had been old and wrinkled for the 20 years that I had known her. So here in the beginning itself about the grandmother, it is like here referred as like our also grandmother. Common thing it is, in a very simple language author used it. Then one more important concept about the grandmother it is given. and that is, as for my grandmother, being young and pretty, the thought was almost revolting. So now in old age, how someone will be pretty, young? But here, author is talking about the past also, that here author is not having that imagination, belief or understanding that a grandmother would be young and pretty years before. So he is not able to think or convince himself. It is mentioned here. Then one more thing here we can understand. She often told us of the game she used to play as a child. And we can hear, this is also general, that grandparents, they are always sharing different tales or games or so many information connected with the things. One more important again reference here we can give, in that seemed quite absurd and undignified on her part, and we treated it like the fables of the prophets she used to tell us. So here the word is used, absurd. That seemed quite absurd and undignified. So absurd means it is illogical in a sense, and undignified, not that much having the dignity, respect for that, because one more thing, it is on her part, and we treated it like the fables of the prophets he used to tell us. Means here she used to tell so many stories, so treatment it is given on the part of author, on the part of others, here children, it is like the, what is like fables of the prophets she used to tell us. So this is the beginning of the lesson, and in the beginning of the lesson author had given clear understanding about the two characters, that is grandmother's character and then grandfather's character. Then ahead in the next passage, author used some more expressions, more words to describe the character of grandmother. In that, author used again some more words. She had always been short. So here the word short, fat, slightly bent. So appearance of the grandmother, it is here clearly we can understand. And then especially about the face. So how is the face? The face is here mentioned. Expressions are like this, that her face was a crisscross wrinkles running from everywhere to everywhere. So this is the reference here. When you will have the wrinkles on the skin, and especially your skin when it will be loose, then that skin can move from here. And so like this here, expression means we can visualize the thing. Then one more thing here. No, we were certain she had always been as we had known her. So here some more expressions or more information about the grandmother here Pushpan Singh is providing to the reader, and that is old. She was not only old, so terribly old. Nowadays, life due to lifestyle, we are just thinking that at least 60 or 70 age, but here old, grandmother's age is not mentioned, but old, so terribly old that she could not have grown older. And here one more thing it is explained, that she could never have been pretty. Means that innocence, that prettiness in the old age, how author would image. But one more here statement, it is, but she was always beautiful. But in this case here, but she was always beautiful. Beautiful means the senses here are different. The beauty of the mind, beauty of the thought, good deeds, spirituality, religious, so many things here. Again, afterwards, author used, means Khushwant Singh specially highlighted. And in the appearance also, white beard word is used for the grandfather. Here you can observe that her silver locks were scattered untidily over her face. And what type of face? Pale. Her pale puckered face. So here we can understand, again author or the Khushwant Singh is highlighting some features or the appearance of the grandmother. In that grandmother's hairs also, like a silver locks means silver hair, white and little bit untidy, means there is no such type of fashion or something here we are observing. So this is the clear understanding, clear picture, appearance of the grandmother. And due to old age, the face is looking like a pale puckered face. Then one more information regarding the grandmother here. She was like the winter landscape in the mountains, an expanse of pure white serenity, breathing peace and contentment. So here the winter landscape, it is always fresh, peaceful, and everybody likes that appearance. Everybody likes, when you will go and observe, you will feel comfort. So the same comfort, it is also there, same comfort, it is also observed in relation with the grandmother. So grandmother's behavior, grandmother's nature, here indirectly author is trying to reflect through some expressions. In that expression specially, earlier some lines I will refer for you. In that, she hopped about the house in spotless white, with one hand resting on her waist to balance her stoop, and the other telling the beads of her rosary. Means she used to pray, and that spirituality, religious view and such type of nature, it is not harmful to the any person, because they are involved in their good thoughts, or they are in the phase of the thinking about the God, or the thinking about only the positivity. So here she was like the winter landscape in the mountains, an expanse of pure white serenity, breathing peace and contentment. And her behavior, her life, it is the full of peace, and that peaceful nature is required for everyone, and that is the main understanding. And one more thing here, contentment, that feeling of when's equilibrium, all the tranquility of the thoughts and that peaceful nature. So through this we can easily understand that how the author here trying to convince the reader that how is the grandmother. And after discussion, then author will start thinking about the next, means the phase, first phase, second phase, third phase. So in the first two passage, author had given more focus about the in first passage two characters, and in the second passage only about the grandmother. And now in the next passage, beginning is very important. My grandmother and I were good friends. So here, how is the relation? Like a friends. Grandmother used to behave with the author like friend, and there is a good bonding. So friendship means the good bond. There is no any kind of tension here Khushwant Singh was experiencing, and in this especially the routine is discussed. What is that routine? Means she used to wake up the author, and then she used to keep all the things ready for the author, especially ready for the school, and then breakfast. But here one more again important thing it is mentioned, that the company of the grandmother. So here she used to go with the author, and some here expressions first I will refer for you. Why she used to go there and what was her special habit? So in that habit, here prayer was the main source, and when she used to sing that prayer, she said her morning prayer is monotonous. Sing song while she bath and dressed me, in the hope that I would listen and get to know it by heart. So intention of the grandmother, that when she is singing that prayer, author will also listen it and author will by heart, and afterwards means all grandparents they are teaching or they are preaching their grandchildren in very nice way. So here the basic intention of the grandmother is author will also learn by heart that prayer, and afterwards he will also sing. One more again thing here it is explained about, I listened because I loved her voice but never bothered to learn it. So here author is explaining or giving more details about the his behavior. He listened it, he used to listen that because there was a love about the grandmother. But this is the first phase childhood phase, and children are innocent, and in that innocent stage everybody likes the grandparents, and they will never leave the grandparents because they would enjoy the company of the grandparents. So here also author is enjoying the company of the grandmother. And here are some more details again author had given, and that is the one more detail about that first page, village life. Then she would fetch my wooden slate which she had already washed and plastered with yellow chalk. Then one more here, okay, this is the just information about that, but afterwards author is talking about the breakfast, and there is a reference about the love for animal. That is, in this reference if we will notice, then we can understand that the character of the grandmother was good. So she was the good lady, religious lady. So here we can refer that after a breakfast of a thick stale chapati with a little butter and sugar spread on it, we went to school, and she used to take such type of chapatis with them, and what she carried several stale chapatis with her for the village dogs. So means village, it is not only one dog but for village dogs. So this is the love for animal we can understand. And one more thing here it is given, in that my grandmother always went to school with me because the school was attached to the temple. So again this religious attitude it is here discussed. One more again we can understand, the priest taught us the alphabet and the morning prayer. So village life, village setting, prayer means they are thinking that when we are singing the prayer, all good thoughts, positive thoughts would come in our mind and we will never think in negative about any person. So especially here priest or such type of people, they are preaching. And this culture everybody likes, especially the grandmother, or the lady likes the grandmother. Here it is picturized. Then while the children sat in rows on either side of veranda singing the alphabet or the prayer in chorus, so the priest or somebody would say, and then children will give the chorus, they will also sing. My grandmother sat inside reading the scriptures. So here again one more aspect of the grandmother here it is given, that is she would be interested in the scriptures, reading the holy books. Then when we had both finished, we would walk back together, and again there is a company. Means this presence of the mother, here presence of the grandparents, we have to think why here grandmother is happy. Grandmother is happy because her nature is religious nature, and she is getting all that scriptures, holy books to read, then prayer and the company of the grandson. So this important thing here we can understand. And then next the love of the grandson as well as love for the animal, especially here village dogs mentioned. This time the village dogs would meet us at the temple door. They followed us to our home, growling and fighting with each other for the chapatis we threw to them. So this again one important thing here, every day same thing to do for the animals. This nature is very important, right? You are not thinking about only one person, you are not thinking about only family members, but you are thinking about family members as well as the others and other creatures as well. So positive traits of the grandmother's personality here we can notice. This is the first phase, means in question it is asked the three phases of author's relationship with his grandmother before he left the country to study abroad. So three phases in this. First phase we have discussed, then we will think about the next phase. And what is that next phase? The next phase is here when my parents were comfortably settled in the city, they sent for us. That was a turning point in our friendship. Now in the first phase, village life, the beginning of the passage, it is my grandmother and I were good friends. And now there is a change in the schedule change, everything changed. And now so many problems, so many means due to village setting she was comfortable. Now new area, new setting, new things. So in this it is not good to say now. That was a turning point in our friendship. And why a turning point? Everything changed. She may not adjust in new environment. And because of that, there is a turning point in the friendship. Means now the tension you can observe. There is a problem in the relation. Here it is observed. Although we shared the same room. Okay, here common factor is they used to share the same room, only one thing. But now in next phase, new phase, what is the here important thing mentioned? My grandmother no longer came to school with me. In first phase, she used to go with the author. But here it is mentioned that my grandmother no longer came to school with me. And what is the next thing it is here explained in this? I used to go to an English school in a motor bus. So this company of the grandson, it is not there. Now loneliness. Okay, room is one, they are sharing the room. But the phase is here. Author would be there in, and especially the English school. So there all functions, language, then different subjects, and the routine of that school, everything would be different. Their preachings would be different. Their governance would be different. So many things would be different. So grandmother may not like, and especially one more thing, that is the loneliness is the very important factor we can observe. There were no dogs in the streets, and she took to feeding sparrows in the courtyard of our city house. So here dogs were not there, but the nature, suppose you have that feeling of selfless nature, then anywhere you go you will find something to do. So, to give your contribution or help others. So if that attitude, positive attitude, or the love for the animals, birds, if you have in your mind, surely wherever you go, you will have that feeling. So this is here. There were no dogs in the street, and she took to feeding sparrows in the courtyard of our city house. Again, one more information about this same phase it is given. As the years rolled by, we saw less of each other. So here, in the first phase, every day, she used to go with the author for school, again come back. Means that relationship, that friendship was very strong. But in the second phase, there is a turning point in the friendship. One more thing here. For some time, she continued to woke me up and get me ready for school. When I come back, she would ask me what the teacher had taught me. So she was having orthodox view and especially religious thing. So she was expecting from the school also the same, but here English school, so we may not accept the same thing from the everyone. So here, what is the expectation from everyone here? I would tell her English words and little things of Western science and learning. Suppose when you are sharing something, what would happen? Grandmother should also think about whatever the author or the Khushwant Singh is sharing here. Author is sharing about the Western science and the learning, the law of gravity, Archimedic principle, and the world being round. This made her unhappy. And why? Here there is a turning point in the friendship, because she was thinking only about the religious things, the preachings, good things should be taught to the children. But here, different things are being taught. So she was unhappy and there was no understanding about the modern education. Maybe the generation gap, maybe the understanding problem. Maybe she is not able to mold in new environment or a new schooling system. So because of that, there is a thing that unhappiness. She could not help me with my lessons. And now if there you are sad, if you are unhappy, you may not take interest. And the same thing here also we can notice. She did not believe in the things that they taught in the English school and was distressed that there was no teaching about God and scriptures. So she might be thinking that there must be focus, or means they should teach about the God, scriptures, then morality will come, character building. She might be thinking in that aspect. So she was unhappy, she was not satisfied with such type of teaching. One day I announced that we were being given music lessons. She was very disturbed. So here there may be misunderstanding, the prejudice about that. What is that prejudice here? Afterwards it is mentioned. To her, music had lewd association. It was monopoly of harlots and beggars and not meant for gentle folk. See, there is a prejudice that the music or such type of things, it is not for the gentle folk, but it is for the harlots and beggars. So whatever they are thinking, it is totally different. Then one more thing here. She said nothing, but her silence meant disapproval. She rarely talked to me after that. And when she come to know about that, what is the thing that English school, they were teaching such type of music and all, and there is no preaching about the God or the scriptures. And then her mind started thinking negative, and rarely, here the word rare, she rarely talked to me after that. Means in the second phase, this is the turning point of their friendship and the communication day by day, that communication barrier we can observe, and this communication barrier again created the problem. So in the next video we will discuss a third phase and onwards whatever the remaining things. So what you do, read lesson carefully, try to think positive and find out. Suppose you have not searched the meanings, find out the meanings, note down, and whatever you will understand up till this, write synopsis of that paragraph, each paragraph in a brief. Thank you.